was all over, there was little left to salvage. Only one amphibian, secured ashore, withstood the gale. A few days later, amphibians arrived to replace the PBYs that were lost. This disaster will not occur again. Organized communication with Greenland and other meteorological stations has been established to give ample warning in the event of an approaching storm. Fjord, a sheltered retreat for all men of war of the Allied nations. Protected by lofty ice peaks, this deep fjord provides a haven for naval vessels of all classes while refueling and undergoing minor repair. The submarine and torpedo nets guard the entrance to the narrow mouth of the fjord. There is considerable controversy among authorities as to the wisdom of concentrating many warships here. It is argued that apart from being an easy target, it would be a difficult place to evacuate in an emergency. The USS Kearney, after being torpedoed, made for Kvalfjord and was patched up by the Navy's Vulcan before returning to a Boston dry dock. Our camera crew, dispersed on many vessels of a convoy, proceeds toward Halifax. A PBY patrol plane operating from Iceland warns that an enemy submarine has been sighted in the vicinity. An alert is given. All hands to battle stations. From aboard a cruiser, scouting planes are catapulted into the air. The destroyer, taking direction from the scouting planes, drops its deadly ash cans and hits its mark. The signal to cease fire. In the wake of the cruiser, a smoke bomb is dropped. This indicates the direction of the wind and assists the scouting plane in landing in the turbulent waters. A perfect landing. Note how the pilot drops the hook in the tow net. Hoisting planes aboard while underway requires organized and coordinated teamwork. This crew seems to know its business. Convoy reforms and proceeds on its zigzag course. Again, a patrol plane appears overhead. This time it brings news that the British merchantman Wildebeest was torpedoed and sunk, that about 25 members of her crew are afloat in two lifeboats. The USS Lang says that she will go to their rescue, but will require refueling upon her return. The tanker Sapello agrees to stand by to supply the fuel. About 2 days later, after what seemed a hopeless search, the Lang returns with the survivors safely aboard. The refueling operations begin. A ticklish job when done under favorable sea conditions. This was particularly difficult. because both vessels had to keep moving. These waters are sub-infested. The job was done in record time. 37,000 gallons of fuel oil for a crate of canned pineapple. Thank you, Sapello. Well done.